Hi guys, welcome 2024, my word, it's amazing. Okay, I haven't really got back in the saddle yet. It's been jolly hot here in Cape Town, but here I am. I'm starting again and I'm going to throw hopefully a biggish vase with some earthenware clay, and I'm going to take you through the process. The first thing is to get a large lump. It's about 1.5 kilos. Although this tool uses a lot of clay, at least I get the profile at the bottom correct. You can see that, I hope. Tendency to always want to go too fast. I have a nice cylinder now. It's a little bit sort of narrow in the belly and wide at the bottom, which is not what I want. I want the opposite of that. This clay is giving me a hard time to see. Okay, so it's a bit later on in the day. I've decided there was enough wind coming in to dry the top a bit and the bottom. So now I'm going to try throwing some more and just see if I can get the shape I want. Much easier to throw now. I'm nearly there. It's got the shape I want. Just tidy the inside a bit. And then I'm going to finish this off by hand. I prefer to do that, you know, if you throw the basic shape and then finish it off by hand at the end. Excuse the noise. Okay, that looks lovely. So there it is, the shape that I wanted. It's about 25 centimeters high at this stage. Now I'm going to carry on building it by hand off the wheel when it's a bit dry. Morning. So the following morning I decided this was very heavy, so now I'm going to try and open it up from the bottom, build it up, and then add a new bottom to it. Okay, so into hole. Very thick. Okay. kind of an uneven on the top, so I'm just gonna pull the wheel, and then I'll work again. Okay, so I'm gonna join the bottom by using the usual sort of slipping and scoring method. I've cut a little pancake to match the bottom. I've scored that a lot. Now I've got to score the pancake as well. Actually, I have this scorer, which is actually a cooking tool, but I also found this on the beach. Amazing. I don't know what it is. Colin says it's a joint for wood, so I thought, that's my scoring instrument, which I can use here. It's excellent. So I can score that, and then I can score around the base. Great tool. You don't have to buy anything. Just go to the beach, and you'll find all the tools you need for pottery. Okay, score that and wet it well. Some nice slippy water. Doing with one hand and then attach it onto the top using fingertips or tools or whatever you have. Join the two together. I can't do that with the video on, but I'll show you the finished.
Okay, so the bottom is on. You can see.
And then now I just see that inside there is a bit of the best thing to do is to make a thin coil and put it down at the bottom and then, you know, gently ease it into place. Okay, now that the inside is fairly clean, I'm happy I joined up, actually decided to use a little coil in the join at the bottom seam there. Now my choice is the wheel and throw more, but I prefer doing handwork at this stage. I like the nice relaxing business of handwork, and at the moment we have builders at the so it's not very relaxing at this space, so I'm going to just try and zone out and do some handwork. And then, you know, sometimes your pots speak to you. They tell you what they want to be. And when I looked at this, I thought, oh, it's quite fish-shaped, you know, it's got that sort of fishy feel. So this is going to be my lucky fish bowl, and I'm going to decorate it with fishes. I usually do animals, you know, mammals or some sort, but I think the fishes deserve some coverage because they're having a bad time in the sea at the moment, I think. Anyway, about an hour in, there are places that are recovering, which is very good. So yeah, it's recovered coral. I want to make that a feature.